I'm Dr. Allison McGeer, and I'm a microbiologist and infectious disease epidemiologist at Sinai Health System in Toronto. I'm here to talk to you about what to expect if you need to be tested for COVID-19. If you think you need to be tested, what do you do? Well, the first thing you want to do is check with your family doctor to sort out whether you do need to be tested or not. And you want to start that process on the telephone, because if you do need to be tested for COVID-19, it's important for people to know that you might have it and to be taking the proper precautions. If you and your doctor decide between you that you do need to be tested, it may be that your doctor will have all the equipment to do it in the office. It's more likely that your doctor will send you to the emergency department to be tested there. There's two kinds of tests that are done. They both use the same swab, and this is what it looks like. It's a very small and quite flexible swab, and it's got a little brush on the end. And the nurse will put it into your nose, curl it up to the back of your nose, and then rotate it so that that brush brushes the cells in the back of your nose, goes into the tube, gets sealed up, and then the tube gets sent off to the lab for the test. Does it hurt to get one of these swabs done? It doesn't hurt as much as it's uncomfortable. It's just kind of an odd sensation when somebody is putting a brush, even a very small one, at the back of your nose, but it's not usually painful, and it's not the least bit dangerous. The reason that it's a swab of your nose is because this virus lives in the lining of the back of your nose and down the back of your throat. At the moment, many of the tests are being done in reference labs because the tests are new and we want to make sure they're right. And so sometimes it can take a day or two. As we move tests into regular hospital labs, we'll often be hoping to deliver the tests in 6 or 8 hours from the time you have your swab done. And that's in part because you want to know whether you have the infection, but it's also because it makes a big difference if the hospital's taking care of you to know whether the extra precautions are needed to take care of you. If you get sick, how do you know whether you've just got influenza or whether you've got COVID-19? And the answer is, you can't tell. This is a problem for all respiratory viruses, which is that although statistically, when you look at a large population, there may be some differences, when one person has a respiratory tract infection, you cannot tell whether it's seasonal influenza or rhinoviruses or COVID-19 or one of the many other causes of infection. The only way you can be sure about it is to do a lab test and look for the particular genetic material of each virus. So what happens if you test positive for COVID-19? It's important to remember that most people who get COVID-19 have mild illness. In general, the cases that we've seen in Canada have been people who've not been sick enough to need to be in the hospital. So you will get sent home with instructions on how to do self-isolation at home. And you'll be in touch with your public health department, who will help you if you have questions and who will arrange for testing so that you know when you no longer have the virus and you can come out of isolation and go back to your usual life. So if you've had COVID-19 and recovered from it, can you get it again? We don't know yet. It looks, from what we know about the immune system, as if when you've had it once, that's going to be it and you can't be reinfected again. But we're not going to know that for sure until we've had enough activity and enough people have been exposed again and not gotten infected. That's really the acid test.